I was a postdoc doing some cancer work at the Massey Cancer Center here in Richmond. I didn't think I would end up at a tobacco company, but there was an opportunity to come. I thought I would just check it out. When I came in and was interviewing for the postdoc, I really liked the people that I was working with. I decided to take the position, and I've been here for the next almost 18 years. My team runs clinical studies, which is really human studies that require biological samples. So we look at nicotine concentrations in the blood, we look at exposure markers in different fluids. We have to spend a lot of time with the robustness and the data integrity of our science. We follow good clinical practice. It's really important to understand that the work that we're doing is really done at the highest quality that can be done. The FDA has a tough job, and they're not just going to take our word for it. They're going to need the data to support all of our statements, and that evidence is helped to create how they pull everything together to really show that it is appropriate for the protection of public health for these products to be on the market. The non-combustible space is really where people are headed. When you burn something, it creates a lot of bad constituents. And so as we move people to those non-combustible products, we need to show, give the research and the science that supports that moving from those cigarettes to those other products is really the appropriate thing for them to do. And so we look at exposure markers that really show that those things are not occurring, that exposure to those bad actors are not occurring in these new products as you're using them.